Welcome everyone to the Model 3 unveil.
Since its debut in 2017, the Tesla Model 3 has been the best-selling electric car along with its new crossover sibling model, the Model Y. But unlike other automakers, Tesla does not update its vehicles every year. Tesla has just started contacting Model 3 reservation holders in the United States to ask if they are interested in converting their orders to a new version equipped with lithium-iron phosphate batteries instead of the usual nickel-cobalt-aluminum automotive oxidation batteries, in North America very common in Model 3 cars. The Model 3 is the fastest-selling electric car in Western Europe thanks in part to its strong range claims, while distance boasts from its competitors wilt under examination. While Tesla must send Autopilot data to feds by October 22, Tesla FSD Beta is currently testing in Europe. At the same time, Tesla Gigafactory in Nevada celebrated 1 million battery packs, and the company seems to have a genius plan that gas vehicles can never beat. Finally, a video showed someone crashing Tesla into the warehouse at high speed. Playing games with your friends is fun until you not only smash your car, but also smash a privately owned building, and so it was. So let's review all the details. Before we start, however, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it, subscribe to Technopool, and hit the bell icon for notifications. As such, the 2017 model, the 3rd of May, looks similar to the one purchased today, but there are important differences under the skin. Model 3 long range embodies everything that makes Tesla a leading electric car of its kind, a wide range of 353 miles, use of Tesla's huge supercharger network, amazing performance of 0 to 60 miles per hour in 4.2 seconds, and autopilot driver assistance. All of these features are packaged in a small, simple, flexible and comfortable vehicle that costs $49,990. Speaking of range and battery, Tesla just started contacting Model 3 reservation holders in the United States to ask if they would be interested in changing their order to a new version of the car equipped with LFP batteries. First of all, we will say that there are a lot of technical details about various battery chemistries. With that being said, we will always encourage you to have a detailed conversation on this topic and share your wisdom in the comments below. However, for everyday Tesla drivers, it actually boils down to several key details: cruising range, charging time, safety and lifespan. As you may already know, Tesla sells Model 3 with LFP batteries outside of North America. For some time, people have thought that LFP model the 3rd of May finally reached the States, and now these rumors have come true. As we said before, Tesla recently sent an email to Model 3 Standard Range Plus reservation holders, most of which may be waiting for a long time to finally receive their car, asking if they would be willing to switch to LFP Model 3. The car would have about 10 fewer miles of EPA estimated range, but they'd likely be able to take delivery much sooner. Model 3 is the fastest-selling electric car in Western Europe, partly because of its strong cruising range, and the distance between it and its competitors is being tested. Volkswagen and its many brands are putting pressure on this leadership position. The competition is strengthening its electric vehicle engineering and seeking technological improvements to match and surpass Tesla. Tesla has not yet been threatened by mass-market brands, but if the company decides to expand into a cheaper price range, this may happen in the medium term. At least in the short term, the seemingly impressive range will differentiate it from its opponents. The overall market leadership of Model 3 is surprising because it's much more expensive than Volkswagen ID.3, and sometimes even three times the price of a small Renault Zoe. According to Schmidt Automotive Research, in the first 7 months of 2021, Tesla sold 66,683 Model 3s, almost twice as many as the second-place Volkswagen ID.3s with 35,481 sales and 27,881 Renault Zoes. Add in the 27,881 ID.4 SUVs, 20,906 small Volkswagen EUPs, and various Skodas, Seats, Audis and Porsches, and you might argue that the Volkswagen Group and all its brands are already in the leading position. In the next 5 years, Volkswagen will spend about $55 billion to electrify all its brands of cars and SUVs. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration has asked Tesla to provide extensive data on its autopilot driver assistance system as government agencies are advancing investigations into autopilot-related accidents. The administration is currently investigating several car accidents in which Tesla apparently ran into a parked emergency vehicle with autopilot enabled and caused personal injury or other damage. Tesla must hand in data before October 22, This includes detailed information about which vehicles it has sold or equipped with autopilot and the system's operating parameters. In a public document that was also sent directly to Tesla, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration asked the company to provide a list of Tesla equipped with the company's self-driving technology, including the hardware and software versions used by the car. As well as the information of each collision, the company knows that it involves a vehicle equipped with an autopilot. The administration also requested precise details of autopilot operating limits, including maximum steering angle and maximum acceleration and braking rates. The document also requires detailed information about how the autopilot system interacts with the driver, including a list of conditions that can cause the system to disengage, and details of how and when driver input can override autopilot's functionality. The focal point of the investigation is 12 collisions between Tesla and emergency vehicle suspension. When the investigation was launched a few weeks ago, only 11 car accidents were under investigation. However, the collision of a Model 3 with a highway patrol car in Orlando, Florida last Saturday became the 12th accident on the NHTSA list. The owner of the Model 3 claimed that autopilot was activated at the time of the accident. If the administration determines in its investigation that Tesla's autopilot system is unsafe, it may force the company to recall cars or repair them to correct any safety flaws. The administration estimates that any such repairs could affect as many as 765,000 Teslas produced between 2014 and 2021. Tesla FSD Beta is currently being tested in Europe. The update was hinted at by the famous Tesla owner Hacker Green the Only, who said that the company's code shows that some vehicles in Europe are currently running FSD Beta. The respected hacker did not specify the specific FSD Beta version that European testers are reported to be running, but he pointed out that the owner of the limited program still adheres to a strict confidentiality agreement. FSD beta testing outside the United States does not seem to be limited to Europe. The owner hacker later added that some Teslas in China appear to be running advanced driver assistance systems. It is true that Tesla's autopilot training in China is very different due to local government regulations, but the appearance of obvious FSD beta testers in the country indicates that the company is working hard to bring its fully autonomous driving beta version to foreign car owners of the states. Considering that FSD beta is expected to see some substantial improvements in the coming days, these updates are very exciting. On Twitter last month, Tesla CEO Elon Musk stated that the FSD beta 10, which will be launched later this week, will have a completely retrained neural network. After the release of FSD Beta 10, Musk pointed out that it may only take a few weeks of adjustments and bug fixes before the company launches the highly anticipated beta and long-awaited FSD to a larger group of EV owners. Speaking of success, the Tesla Gigafactory 1 in Nevada has achieved a major milestone in the production of 1 million EV battery packs since 2017. We assume that this figure includes only the electric vehicle sets of Tesla Model 3 and Tesla Model Y and possibly some other prototype cars. At the beginning of the construction, Tesla stated that the battery output in 2020 will reach 35 gigawatt-hours per year, and the annual output of battery packs will reach 50 gigawatt-hours using batteries from other places. It is expected to be enough to produce 500,000 electric vehicles per year. These plans were very ambitious, but they were delayed and changed. Currently, the company expects to build a new battery and battery pack factory in Tesla Giga Austin, Texas. Not only is it closer to the EV assembly, but also a new type 4680 cylindrical battery cell will be used. Remember when every new Tesla car purchased was eligible for the $7,500 federal tax credit? If you have a tax liability to take advantage of it, this is a very good deal. Over the years, it can be said to help boost Tesla's sales. However, credit has disappeared, and it has been for some time, but this has not stopped people from flocking to buy Tesla. With the exception of electric vehicles produced by General Motors, most other new electric vehicles are still eligible for credit. Although this means that Tesla's competitors can receive up to $7,500 in rewards, and Tesla owners cannot receive federal tax credits, the Silicon Valley automaker still sells more electric vehicles than any other brand. Model 3 is the world's best-selling electric car, and Model Y is quickly catching up. To sum up, the company seems to have a genius plan that gas vehicles can never beat. There is a new potential incentive or rebate program being thrown out, which may mean that people who buy Tesla can get a credit of $10,000. If credit is available, Tesla's sales are likely to increase substantially, which makes sense. The $10,000 credit will make part of Tesla's starting price at least equal to that of gasoline cars. In addition, certain cars of the brand may actually end up being much cheaper than their gasoline-powered competitors. The pleasure of an electric car lies in the momentary torque it obtains when it goes offline. With a single tap on the accelerator, you can quickly reach 60 miles per hour, and from there you can speed up without much effort. The problem is that inexperienced drivers may lose control, especially if they drive through a parking lot at high speed, and may eject the vehicle into the air in the process. This is the case with the video that the driver of the Tesla Model Y was filmed before crashing into a warehouse in Orlando, Florida. However, there is a copy on the Facebook page of Paul Marich, an Australian car journalist and Model 3 owner. Fortunately, no one seemed to be injured in the car or at the warehouse. If this group continues to create such content, it may not be the case next time. We hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to leave your comment in the section below, and please don't forget to like and subscribe and be sure to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. There are many more future-focused tech videos coming soon, so until then stay tuned, and we'll see you in the next video.